sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, for the grace and all thanksgiving, be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, for the grace and all thanksgiving, be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, for the grace and all thanksgiving, be every moment thine.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Dear sisters and brothers, the fifth promise that is given in the book of Genesis is Book of Genesis chapter 13 verses 15. And all the land that you see, I will give to you and your offsprings forever. I will make your offerings like the dust of the earth, so that if one can count the dust of the earth, your offsprings also can be counted. Dear friends, if you go through the promises that God has given in the life of Abraham, can be counted seven. Seven promises are given to Abraham. These seven promises can be summarized into three. The first one was land. Second is offsprings. The third one is universal salvation. So these three promises, especially God has given to him. Land, that was a great desire for the people of Israel. Because Abraham and his descendants, they were nomads. They were shepherds. They were going from one place to another as searching for the grass for the sheep. And they were not having a proper place, a permanent house. So they were praying and they were having a great desire to have a permanent house, a permanent land for them. But here, God is giving a land, a promise to land. But once we go through the history of the Bible, in the life of Abraham, this promise is not being fully actualized or fulfilled. That was being fulfilled in the life of Joshua. Ever cherished dream of their life, they kept, and something was being fulfilled. He was being blessed with the child. But the promise was being fulfilled later in his generations. Dear friends, God promises us. God blesses our life. Sometimes those blessings, those plans that may not be able to complete within your life, you may not be able to experience that, but those promises will be fulfilled in your generations. Look at the promise to land for which Moses was guiding the people of Israel. As they were traveling, there was a great troubles that they had gone through. Severe drought, their famine, no proper food, they were thirsty. They had gone through 40 years of a desert experience. But at the end, even though Moses could not see the promise to land, but the next generation, in the life of Joshua, and the people could experience that, they could get that promise to land. Dear friends, even today, this passage has got a greater importance. We Christians, we are travelers. We are traveling. We are traveling towards a promised land. For us, the promised land is of eternity or eternal life or heaven. We are traveling. As we are the passengers, the travelers, and one day we will be reaching to the destinations. And as we are in the season of Lent, the Lord is reminding us, so we have to look at God, we have to look at Jesus and go forward. I remember few years back from Delhi, as I was invited to a house, I was driving the car, and the house owner, he was driving another vehicle, and he was telling me, "Father, you just follow me." And I was driving the car. As I was traveling ahead, and after some times, because of the turning and the traffic block, I lost the vehicle which was going ahead. I thought that the vehicle which I am seeing before looking like the same, but that was not the exact vehicle. And I just traveled, just followed. At the end, that vehicle reached in a house. Once I reached there, I came to know that the vehicle was wrong. Dear friends, it gives a spiritual insight to us. We too are following. And we have an intention, and we have a great intention before us, where to reach. But sometimes we may lose the vehicles that is going on, going ahead us, which is helping. If you are not giving proper attentions, we may reach, but not on the proper place, but on the wrong place. Therefore, what the Lord is telling, we have a promise to land. In this Lenten season, taking the little sacrifices, that let us go ahead. Let us make sure that the vehicle going ahead is a proper vehicle. We are looking at Jesus. Jesus is our guide. Let us look at the Lord and go ahead in our life. Close our eyes. Offer ourselves as the Lord's grace and blessings to us. Let us praise our Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Father. We praise you, Jesus. We glorify you, Jesus. We adore you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. We praise you, Jesus. Jesus. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.